And now we're starting our prep on going to Cloud City.
Yo, wait a minute. He didn't seriously get bumped all the way to 100 million berries after Crocodile, did he?
Yes, because Crocodile's bounty was 80 million.
Oh my god! Holy shit.
You didn't know what his bounty was?
No, I didn't offhand. Well, I mean, Warlord, I assumed that he wouldn't have one.
They're former bounties.
Oh.
They're former bounties, and then their bounties are revoked, so that way they don't have any Marines or anyone or bounty hunters coming after them.
That'll explain it, yeah.
Defeat the pirate captain within the time limit is enough, and defeat the mysterious intruders. That's going to be a little tricky, actually, because in this stage, it's beat one of two enemies before the other one.
All right. So,
press the start button.
I don't think I need to explain what we're going to be using for this stage.
No.
No.
I'm not. You can't force me. Pre-sucks.
Eh. I'm not forcing you to do anything. As for me, I have, like, all the best outfits under the sun to work with. Bombshell intensifies. Alright. God, where do I begin? Alright, maybe not the hat kind of ruins it for me.
No. You can take it off, but no.
You can?
Yeah, your taunt takes off and puts on a hat.
Sweet.
Pre-time skip anyways.
The world.
Her post-time skip is her putting on her sunglasses.
So, which one?
Not that one.
I think it's alright. I like the hips, though.
I still hate the
shoulder pieces. This.
Huh?
Kaihime it is.
I don't think you picked that one. I think you actually ended up picking Shinksai.
I'm cool with both.
Who is this lady? We've never seen her before.
Oh, the leather. Hello. Also, Zoro's face. God. To be fair, that would be my exact face if I saw Robin on my ship.
Wasn't that one of your Skype icons for a while?
Yeah, I post on Tumblr.
Ow.
It might have been. I don't know. Also, this is why I'm much more distracted by boobs than anything else. You're distracted by VV. I am 110% distracted by Robin.
I'm distracted by any boobs that are on screen.
I have to like what's attached to the boobs.
Yes.
And Robin, absolutely.
She made herself at home within 2 minutes of being on the boat.
Her introduction sequence to the Straw Hats is fucking gold.
You know, the funnier thing, you've seen that, right?
Yeah.
The funnier thing I find hilarious.
God, she's beautiful.
The funny thing I find hilarious is that when she first walks outside of the door, outside of the room she's been hiding in, Nami actually comments that she's wearing Nami's clothes.
I think I missed that one, actually. And meanwhile, San just freaking out. What the fuck you do with her, man? Great.
Still going?
Yeah, just checking it. I just glance over once in a while to make sure. He's like, oh, okay. Naturally, everyone has some objections to this. I think everyone. I think Zoro is still the one person who hasn't like fully bought into her joining yet.
No. So what's funny is this is actually past where you are. They're melding this into the same day. The same day that Robin joins, apparently, is the same day that ships are falling from the sky.
Yeah, I still haven't got to this part yet.
This is officially where we end the majority of Boober's knowledge.
Yep, basically. Now Bob's going to uncharted territory.
For the third time. Second.
Second
and a half.
Something like that.
Pirate Warriors 1 and 2.
Well, yeah.
This second and a half time. They cover Skypiea, kind of, in the beginning of Pirate Warriors 2.
Smidgen, yeah.
So apparently out of nowhere, islands are... islands.
Guess that would be fucking awesome.
And I got blasted into the... Look at that guy. He's so happy to get drunk on a Friday night.
Dude, if I knew I had a mullet and a mohawk, fuck yeah.
You should try that sometime. Enter Bellamy. I love this asshole. He's great.
Voiced by Raditz and everything.
Yes. And I've already talked to... We were like 6 months ago, but what I want this part to be named to be, and I want it to still be this. Don't diss the power of Boing. And that's not going to make sense now, but it will way later.
Mm.
And it's beautiful.
Is that a 4Kids thing, or is that a
No, thing? That's from this game. That's a line in this game.
Awesome.
That he says way later in the game. Don't diss the power of Boing.
Yeah.
Bellamy is also a very interesting, very well-rounded character. as he starts off as a jackass, which I love, but he also rounds out and develops into something amazing.
Sweet.
Also, I just like a macho pirate wearing a pink tank top.
Yeah, right? He's just missing a pink shirt that says Bad Man on the back of it. All that Virginia.
All the vegan.
That still needs to be fucking up in a DBZ game one of these days.
I'm amazed that wasn't in Budokai 1.
Yeah, no shit. I'm amazed that wasn't in, like, Xenoverse. The game with all the fucking DLC. Hi.
Hi! Clearly not evil man. This is also not where we meet him, by the way. We meet Blackbeard in the bar. In the bar, Luffy and Blackbeard are fighting over pies and beer. Luffy says this is the best beer he's ever had, while Blackbeard says it's the worst beer he's ever had. Blackbeard says this is the best pie he's ever eaten. Luffy says this is the worst pie he's ever eaten. And thus start their world of differences.
Amazing.
And then Luffy ordered 50 steaks.
Yeah, if I had money, I would probably go too.
And Blackbeard ordered 50 pies.
What's Zoro looking at? He looks kind of down. Poor guy.
He's confused by this random asshole they don't know asking questions.
Yeah, true.
So I like how it took 9 episodes for Nami to be playable. Thanks, game.
Well, I guess it also took this long for it to be a completely forward character to actually have a fight that transpires in here.
She doesn't do anything in this stage either. She does more in Alabasta than she does here.
I mean,
for Drum Kingdom, yeah, but for Alabasta, she did stuff. Not very much stuff, but she definitely did stuff.
Yeah. So, remind me again, there was a shit falling from the sky, but how does that translate into them wanting to actually go to Skypiea?
Because if there's because if there are ships falling from the sky, that means there are islands in the sky, meaning more places to adventure.
I can buy it as an answer. Okay.
That's all the excuse Luffy needs.
Yeah.
I mean, that's Luffy.
It's Luffy, yeah.
Luffy's literal answer to everything is take me where the party is.
He is life of the party, after all.
But so they all go to this island because they find out that there are some people that know what's up here and can help them get there. So I don't know if the cutscene at the end of the stage actually shows off the remodeled Mary properly, but they give Mary chicken wings and a little neck and the little head waddle thingy.
That's adorable.
The rooster waddle. It's cute. And somehow putting wings on a boat makes it fly.
Okay, I can buy it.
With that. Gonna check yours?
Yeah.
You have the time increasing one already on there.
Yeah, pretty much all I really need right here.
Sure.
I'll give it a shot. Why not? I was always thinking about using leadership, but I never actually got around to doing it.
It's not one I've ever found you really need very much.
Yeah, since you usually catch her places. Yep, I got the Kaihimi one. Also, nice. if you talk with her, some glasses.
Solid. Red glasses. That lines. You need to.
That works too.
I think it's based on.
Sir, please move out of the way. You're blocking the view.
I'll kill him.
Let's try it again.
Robin, please stop talking. We're trying to look at you.
Right?
Okay, now try it.
Oh, I already did.
Okay. Then this is the part where we get sad that this game doesn't have victory animations.
Yeah, okay. Her victory animations were amazing, Pirate Warriors 2. And the first game, also.
Yeah. Right. So Nami was great in the last game, she's even better here. She throws out the lightning even faster.
She's usable now. It's great.
She was great in 2 also. It's only in 1 that she was garbage. She was aside Chopper notwithstanding, she was the worst character in the game.
Yeah.
Because her attacks didn't work like at all unless you did the setup. At this game, even if you miss with them, you at least have melee attacks because your weapon is also a staff.
Yep.
I can also just apparently throw the sun at you.
All them thunderclouds, though.
Oh, yeah, she can positively nuke most screens if you give her about 10 seconds. Also, the treasure, one of the treasure events for this stage is going to be defeat mysterious invaders. There's going to be two of them. You're going to want to go after one of them in particular, not the other one. Because if you do it in the wrong order, the event doesn't trigger.
Well, now.
I'll talk more about it when we get there, because that's going to be probably about 5, maybe 10 minutes. Okay, I'll take that bottom one, you take the one on the right.
Sure.
It's also nice just being in a regular town again, because everywhere else we've been has been an island or a kingdom or whatever. It's just a regular-ass town. It's been a while since we've been there.
Back in civilization, now. Also, holy shit, all the money. Desert.
Yes.
We haven't really gotten bombarded by money yet in this game. This is amazing.
I've been... Okay, Saul. I've been personally trying to avoid using keys enough for that, because the money sound is really annoying.
Yeah, it's also going to spike the audio.
So what do you think of Saul Bad Guy's new glasses?
Snazzy. Also, not a big fan of the new bandana, though, but well, not bad. He's keeping in shape. He used to get some shampoo, though.
What about his new jacket?
Interesting. Yeah, I'm sure he needs to wear something on his day off. Where he's not hunting down under gears.
I just like the red Charlie Brown shirt with the stripe going all the way across it.
And the giant chain going across.
His neck.
Yeah, right. It looks less like a necklace and just more like... Almost like Dante's nipple belt from DMC3. Almost, but not to extreme.
This is not what we call the bling bling. That stuff needs to shine, not creak. Chains creak, they don't shine.
You know you got the wrong bling on when you need to apply WD-40 to it. And oh my god, you can see all the leather on it right now.
Yes.
Oh. Thanks, Luffy. So, what else we got around here?
I can now throw out tornadoes.
Sweet.
Which I don't remember if I used to be able to do that before, but if I was, they're bigger tornadoes.
Yeah.
Also, the storm clouds are residual, so they stay around for a long time.
Alright, let me just...
You doing grab?
Yeah, I just want to make sure it's still grab for level 2.
It's still grab. They're never going to come up with anything else because she hasn't done anything in several years.
Also, why would you want anything else, really? It's like probably one of the single strongest moves you can have against a boss fight, really.
Yeah, but if you're not in a boss fight or if you're on a stage that doesn't have a typical boss.
Yeah, that's true.
Because if you're not, then it's basically worthless because it only targets one enemy.
Ooh, a messenger.
Kill that shit. Man, please. Thank you.
With the other Robin. Two Robins on the screen at the same time.
That is a thing that is doable.
I love it.
Robin can clone herself.
Look at this.
She can awesome. She can make magic clones that pop up out of the ground. Which base are you in?
Still in the middle somewhere. Her level 1 is very amazing, though.
It is
hell of a range increase.
Great for crowds. Some characters I found either got range, massive range buffs, or massive range nerfs.
Kuzan definitely got a massive range nerf.
So did my favorite character.
Enru?
Yeah.
I think Enru is still pretty damn good anyway.
No, he's still great, but... See, that's the funny thing is, his first Musou got a massive range buff, his second Musou got a massive range nerf.
Yeah, the trajectory definitely changed.
And the Raigo is definitely the better of the two.
Yep.
Let's count. This is actually important because Bellamy's bounty is only 55 million berries, and Zoro's bounty, which is his first bounty, is now 60 million berries.
Jeez.
So they're basically trying to tell him, boss, you're strong and all, but run, these guys are gonna murder you.
That's a very polite way of putting it, yes.
And Bellamy is very much the kind of guy that's like, I'm gonna punch you in the face if you say I'm not strong.
You're not considering it to the fact that there's probably a reason why he's so strong. Or why he has that much of a bounty on him.
Well, the thing is, as he says right now, he thinks it's a fake. And my meter keeps falling. Okay, so let's destroy some bases.
I'm gonna make a tag team with myself. Awesome.
Sweet.
Base destruction incoming.
Oh, hey, you're here too.
Yay.
Ladies, teamwork.
So, you know what just occurred to me?
What?
You want me to call this part, they'll underestimate the power of Boing, and we're using both these characters at the same time?
I knew what I was doing. I picked Nami before you picked Robin.
Yeah, but I kind of gave the heads up I was going to be choosing Robin in advance.
Yes, but I also was doing this because this is the first stage that Nami's playable in.
Yep.
And being honest, it's one of very few that she's playable in because pretty much everyone disappears in Chapter 4. Ugh. Most people are back in Chapter 5, but in Chapter 4, fucking everyone is gone.
That's the one with Marineford, right?
That's the one with Sabote Archipelago, Impel Down, Marineford, and Marineford.
Yep. I'm gonna nuke that messenger. Oh, grab his nuts. Yep, nut grab, inbound, and... I'm so sorry, my friend.
While we're climbing for the future, Impel Down, do you want to be Crocodile, or do you want to be, what's his name? The Queen of Queens.
Oh.
Ivankov.
I'll be Crocodile.
Okay.
He's really fun. I'm debating on making a guide for him.
Have you ever yet played Ivankov?
I've played him a few times, but he's not quite my style.
He's not that great, but he's very funny.
Oh, yeah, he's hilarious. Don't whiff. Got him, hell yeah.
Okay, we got some guys to take down. Defeat the enemy using power to impress Bellamy pirates. Why are we trying to impress the enemy? Aren't they supposed to be hating us or something?
Make them respect us?
That's not going to do very much of anything for Bellamy.
Yeah, that's the best I got.
Okay, and there's another one.
Kaboom.
Oh god, that sound is annoying.
What sound? Oh, that sound, yeah.
Yes. Thanks, game, for providing an example for me.
All the money ever, but holy shit, yeah, you're right. It'd be hilarious if Burning Bloods brought that sound back somehow.
Oh, dear God, I think... And the bases are gone. I think I would murder something.
Preferably something in the game. So...
Who's that mystery man in the red shirt?
I don't know. Oh, there we go.
Thank you. I like how this NPC, who only appears in two stages, magically has two costumes.
Wait, did he actually just... Yeah, that's right. He did bring up hockey, even though we don't know what the fuck that is.
The first time you actually see the first two times you see hockey, believe it or not, are in Luffy's flashback of Shanks. Where Shanks actually uses Haki to intimidate the Sea King that ate his arm.
No one knew. It wasn't really... It was just implied as like a giant like death glare. That didn't really do anything.
The other first time you see Haki actually is in Skypiea, where like everyone has Haki.
Yeah.
Everyone has the past powers of observation Haki. Beat Blackbeard before you beat Jesus Burgess. Do not go up to Burgess. If you beat Burgess first, you don't get the cutscene.
Sure. Now, where is...
Burgess is the one on the right. Blackbeard is the one on the bottom.
All right, I'll move past Burgess then. Just slide right on by.
That was an annoying one that tripped me up for the longest time, actually, because all it said was defeat the invaders, and I did that many times, and I started with him, and it wouldn't work.
There it is.
And I started with Burgess, and it did not want to work for me.
I'm gonna grab his nuts. No, grab and engage. Shit, I totally missed.
Sorry.
Well, this man's good. Not gonna be doing too well.
You can try it again if you like. Just gonna clear this out for you.
God damn. Excuse me, sir.
Damn it.
Everything going crazy.
Trying to knock the things away from you. Get off my sister.
Yeah, that's cool. Yeah, that grab doesn't do dick.
This one?
No, the actual, like, grab attack. I don't know how to do that with him.
I don't know if you can actually do that or not.
Yeah, I was trying it with him earlier, and...
Okay, he's clear-ish.
Unless he does his level 2 move, so I guess. Alright, let's quickly fire this off. Just create some space. Son of a bitch, the Logia user. Ugh. There we go.
He is ultimate fanfic power. The darkness, darkness, brute.
My SAO original character is going so well.
Death gun.
Please don't tell me that's an actual thing.
That is the name of the first villain from season 2.
Oh, Online. God.
Death gun.
Death gun.
Death gun.
I will only watch that show in dubs now. I can't fuck.
What?
Sword Art Online season 2.
Yeah, well, Michelle Ruff.
Michelle Ruff. But as you say, even Sinon's ass cannot save that show.
Yes. Zoro, please.
You didn't fucking lift.
Get off my sword, fucker, Jesus.
Sword fucker Jesus. Well, there's an interesting chain of words right there.
Zoro is a sword fucker.
I don't think it's Kyaku.
He's on that same level.
Wait.
You got him. We both got him.
Dead.
And, for good measure. Neat. Okay.
I wonder if I should.
And his first name is Jesus. Jesus Burgess.
Yep.
Sword fucker Jesus.
Yep. That should be the name of this fucking part. Sword fucker Jesus. I mean, I'll throw it in the description probably. I don't know. There we go. I was about to say, wonder if I could rename the...
Hello.
Nice. The second Musso of Robin's to the 13 special. Why the fuck isn't that like a grab in the DBZ games? Who do I have to blow over a Namco to get the nut shot as a move?
I think doesn't he do that in his ultimate?
No, he doesn't.
Where he hits him away.
Oh god, I wish. No, he just like grabs him by the neck and chucks them.
Oh.
But Jesus Christ, did he grab just like even like a counter move as a grab move? God damn.
So indecisive, Zoro.
Now it's another Zoro, he who hesitates is lost. Wait, was he losing to against Jesus?
No, he wasn't fighting. They never fought at all, actually. They were just kind of there.
So what's the hesitation with Zoro over here?
He says he needed to fight back against Bellamy's men because the idea is that Luffy and Zoro automatically are at a higher moral standing, so they don't want to pick. They either don't want to pick a fight with someone that's not going to listen to them, or they don't want to fight with someone that's weaker than them.
Huh.
I remember what it was exactly. It's like a fight of ideals, and his complete disrespect of their ideals was not something worth listening to.
Interesting. You know, you could just make the case like, hey, so just don't kill them outright, I guess. I don't know.
I suppose so.
Wooden kendo swords? I don't know, just me.
Pubs.
Actually, for that matter, I'd love to see Zoro try some of his techniques using kendo swords.
Remember that time Zoro played baseball?
Yeah. Remember that time Sanji was playing soccer?
I like that he had time to burn an entire cigarette before the ball made it into the goal.
And he kind of kicked it all the way around the world.
That was just the kickoff, mind you. That wasn't even the actual game itself. That was the kickoff.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Wasn't Buggy the one that was in the goal at that point?
I don't. Yeah, Buggy was goalie. Because goalies are allowed to use their hands.
Poor guy.
It's been a long time since I played soccer.
I haven't played soccer since I was like in 7th grade.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
But no, I was just playing basketball, whatever. Yeah. Kickball too. I was destroying people fucking kickball and soccer and dodgeball.
I was one of those kids that had the unfortunate aim, so whenever I was doing kickball, I would always by accident, I would always kick it into the quote-unquote pitcher's face.
Nice.
Did I ever tell you about the time that back in elementary school, I was banned from playing baseball?
Maybe? I don't know.
There was, back when I was in 5th or 6th, I think it was 5th grade, there was some field trip or something that I was banned from going to because I got in trouble or something, and so me and two other students that didn't get the thing signed or pay for the thing or whatever were forced to actually stay in the 6th grade class and just do work or read books or whatever because there was nothing else for us to do because all the teachers were on the trip. And so when the class went to gym, we did too because we had what the fuck else were we gonna do? That's basically the teacher's lunchtime.
Yeah.
And so we go there. The game of the day was baseball, and I think I'm like the fourth or fifth person up to bat on the second team.
Yeah.
And at the time, I either didn't have a strong grip or I don't remember what it was exactly.
Oh, I see where this is going.
I have a firm and a strong hand, but apparently not a very good grip. When it was my turn to bat, I hit that thing really, really fucking far. Like it left the small little area that was marked as the field.
Yeah.
So I think it would have been a home run, but me not being a very smart or not having very much dexterity, I had a habit of throwing the bat whenever I was about to run.
Oh, you were one of those guys.
So I made the unfortunate mistake, and this was before my school had helmets. I'm the reason my school had helmets. I made the unfortunate mistake of not looking and throwing the bat directly into the pitcher's the catcher's head.
Oh my god!
That was a steel bat.
Wait, that means you would have had to like swing as hard as you can. The bat goes all the way around you, 200 back, and then you let go of it. Holy shit! You must have done like a full 360 with that motion.
Now I think it's I swing. I see it go. Instead of dropping it, I just throw it
behind me. Oh, you just throw it directly behind you?
No, I don't.
What?
What?
No, I mean like you throw it behind you.
Yeah, I throw it behind me because well, actually no, I think I threw it. I didn't throw it like over the shoulder. I threw it sideways behind me, and because of where I was holding, because you don't hold a bat in the middle. You hold it by the end. It kind of spun, and it spun directly into the skull of the catcher.
Huh.
And mind you, we were standing like 6 feet apart, right? 6 to 10 feet apart. So that thing went flying. I hit that. It hit him in the head. The guy was sent crying directly to the nurse because steel bat to the face.
Yeah.
And I was banned from ever playing baseball in elementary school again.
Yeah.
And then the school finally decided to invest in helmets in the year 2005.
Neat. Oh, I have wings now. Chicken wings indeed.
We have chicken wings and a rooster waddle. And I just realized I completely talked through one of my favorite cutscenes in this game. God damn it.
You totally did, but it was about throwing a steel bat at a kid's head.
Yes, it was.
Kudos.
I'm amazed that kid's family didn't sue me.
Yeah.
Because would that be considered assault?
Accidental. More like collateral than anything else.
Collateral?
Basically. I mean, okay, as a kid who had... Okay, I guess we're going on this now. Fuck it. As a kid who was born and raised in a family who absolutely fucking loved baseball back east, because, you know, Boston. Red Sox.
Go Sox.
Basically. It was instilled in me at a very young age. You don't throw the bat when you swing. You just put it down next to you. So I never had that problem, and I always had like a really firm grip anyway.
I never knew that because I enjoyed playing baseball, but I never really watched it very much.
No, I don't mean watching it. It was just something that was taught to me. Because some assholes then I got to go get it after you throw it.
Also, my school was really cheap and really dumb, so if you were in the younger years, instead of actually getting to play the real sports, it would just have you play small random games like Tether or Foursquare or whatever instead, because they didn't want you playing with the actual equipment that cost them money to buy. And more often than not, what really sucked was that they had a thing where like they would make you run a mile before... you would do a bunch of exercises and then run a mile, and then if there was time left, then you might actually get to play a game or something.
By the way, we're still talking about baseball over this. Over, like, the one of the most fun cutscenes in the entire fucking game.
I'd like to preface for the record that because the thing is going straight up, they are standing on the wall.
Yep, yeah, Azora was doing that.
They're standing on the wall and on the door.
Fucking great. Oh, shit, now I'm motivated to go watch more One Piece. I got to see Volume 6 sitting right over there, next to the TV.
Nice.
It's got Sanji on the cover, too.
Nice.
I did okay.
Nice.
Hey, you did a little breaker.
That's not something you're going to be seeing very often, so this is, I guess, a treat.
Yeah, considering we're mostly going to be using straw hats for the good bulk of this.
Yeah. Nami's so adorable.
I've grown an appreciation for her ever since I actually watched the entirety of her arc in dubs.
No, but doesn't she have an adorable face?
Yeah, kind of. Even though I just know it's hiding some way of stealing everyone's money.